President Trump declared an emergency today in Puerto Rico.
Residents were warned to brace for the worst.
Culebra fue una de las islas municipios que recibió los fuertes vientos del huracán Irma.
Maria, expected to become a hurricane later on, its path is actually following the path of Irma.
Puerto Rico está enfrentando por primera vez en unos 85 años un huracán categoría 5.
Que aquí hay que evacuar, hay que hacer desalojo, dejándole saber a todos los ciudadanos que esto es un peligro.
Describe a hurricane, especially one of that magnitude. We were in Bayamon, all the missionaries, we gathered together to pass the hurricane together in the mission office, and it was crazy, it was loud. I remember it started Wednesday at like 3 o'clock in the morning, and we all just woke up when it started. If there was any house that was made of wood, it was gone completely, and I remember thinking about that when I was in the office of all the people in those homes. And you couldn't see anything because it was so just rain and wind. The trees were just sideways completely, the palm trees, and just things flying by. And I remember the next day, Thursday, we got up and it was done. And I remember walking outside and like not recognizing Puerto Rico at all. I didn't think I was in Puerto Rico. When I had arrived originally, it was the greenest place I'd ever seen pretty much in my whole life. Everything was just green everywhere. And then after the hurricane, we stepped outside, it was just brown. There was not one green leaf left anywhere on any trees. The people were really awesome. They responded, at least right away, during the first week, really well to the hurricane. They were willing to give food and water and let us, you know, help us out when we needed it. They were willing to receive help from us, and they were really gracious. And I thought that was really awesome. And I saw a lot of them helping each other. When they were done with their house, they went outside to look for their neighbors, what their neighbors needed, and help them out. And that was really cool. I liked that a lot.
Slaves that came and were doing the sugar plantations. Pretty much the dance consists of a dancer and a drummer, and the dancer is challenging the drummer while this is happening.
So the difference with plena is that it kind of mixes the different cultural backgrounds of Puerto Rico. Like, it includes the Taino, which are the natives of Puerto Rico. And about 100 years ago, in Ponce, the plena music started to appear and everything, and it kind of became a trademark of like Spanish coquetry and culture.
So plena became the newspaper of the people in the city, where they will say all the chisme.
Oh, the gossip, you mean.
Yeah. So the people will, through the dances and the music, they will describe the news, and they will say stuff about politicians and also about natural disasters like hurricanes.
So currently, Bomba y Plena is still the most popular folk dance in the island, so it's still danced and it's still practiced.
Rule, Reggaeton is a music genre which originated in Puerto Rico during the late 1900s. It is influenced by hip-hop, Latin American, and Caribbean music. Vocals include rapping and singing, typically in Spanish. DJ Playero and DJ Nelson were inspired by hip-hop and Latin American music to produce Rhythms, the first reggaeton tracks. As Caribbean and African American music gained momentum in Puerto Rico, reggae rap in Spanish marked the beginning of the Boricua underground and was a creative outlet for many young people. Puerto Rican mainstream acceptance of reggaeton was grown and the genre has become part of the popular culture, including a 2006 Pepsi commercial with Daddy Yankee and Pepsi Company's voice of Ivy Queen as musical spokesman for the Mountain Dew. Puerto Rico's large roster of reggaeton artists include, along with those mentioned above, Voltio, Glory, Wisin y Yandel, Don Omar, Looney Tunes, Calle 13, and Hector el Bambino. This Puerto Rican invasion has captured the hearts of urban Hispanic youth the world over.
Wow.